Upper Egypt Association of Diabetes to invite me to present this work, Diabetes and Erectile Dysfunction Patients. Urologic manifestation of diabetes mellitus, eyes are sexual and urologic, and due to damage induced diabetes to blood vessels and nerves by accumulation of advanced glycosated end products. This leads either diabetic nephropathy or cystopathy or this sexual dysfunction. Sexual dysfunction for men, either abnormal erection or ejaculation for women, have some sexual problem I will discuss later, and some urinary tract infection due to bladder dysenergia. People who keep their diabetes under control can lower their risk of early onset of these sexual and urologic problems. What meant by penile erection? Penile erection is a neurovascular phenomenon due to psychological and hormonal modulation. Upon sexual stimulation, nerve impulses arise from the terminal nerve ending neurotransmitters, which is mainly nitric oxide, leads to relaxation of the vessels. Principal neurotransmitter is the nitric oxide, leads to activation of guanylate cyclase and accumulation of cyclic GMP. This leads to relaxation of sinusoids. This is cyclic GMP and cyclic guanosine monophosphate, which can be degraded by phosphodiesterase to guanosine monophosphate. The phosphodiesterase inhibitors like Viagra act on this step to keep the cyclic GMP in cells. The three steps occurs after this increased blood flow through the cavernous artery, filling trabecular smooth muscles relaxation, and this trap the blood through the sinus. This cavernous artery, when dilated, this is the filling space of cavernous tissue. When it become fully spaced, it compressed against tunica albuginea and prevent the flow of venous out, so the erection occurs. The tumescence, when the cyclic GMP is hydrolyzed, monophosphate to the guanosine monophosphate by phosphodiesterase type 5 inhibitor. Three drugs are available commercial for as a phosphodiesterase inhibitor: sildenafil, vardenafil, and tadafil. It is true that the sexual function progressively decline in healthy aging men. For example, latent period between sexual stimulation and erection increases, erection are less turgid, ejaculation is less forceful, ejaculatory volume decreases, and the refractory period between ejaculation is lengthening. Also, there is a decrease in serum testosterone concentration in the blood. What means a sexual dysfunction? Either retrograde ejaculation, decreased libido, erectile dysfunction. There is no term now for impotence. All the literature discuss erectile dysfunction. What meant by erectile dysfunction? It is defined as, defined as inability to achieve and maintain an erection sufficient for satisfactory sexual intercourse. It is estimated about 20 to 30 million in USA. Although ED erectile dysfunction is a benign disorder, but it is affecting the physical and socio-sexual health and the quality of life of men. Epidemiology, the data show high prevalence of and incidence of erectile dysfunction worldwide. The first large community-based study is a Massachusetts male aging study. Overall prevalence of ED is about 52%, ranging from minimal and moderate and complete ED, 17 to 25 to 9% incidence. This study showed that the incidence of ED in diabetic men was 51 per 1,000 population per year. The men who have diabetes have two or two, three times more likely have ED than the normal one, which has no diabetes, and present earlier by 10 to 15 years also. Research that suggests that ED may be an early marker of diabetes, particularly in men aged 40 years, 45 years old. Sexual dysfunction in diabetic men is underappreciated, is a common and underappreciated complication of diabetes. Despite this, healthcare providers often don't specifically ask their male diabetic patient about sexual function. This results in considerable underdiagnosis because patients are often reluctant or impressed to initiate discussion of this issue by themselves. Risk factor. ED share common risk factor with cardiovascular disease, like lack of exercise, obesity, smoking, hypercholesterolemia, and metabolic syndrome. Some of these are modifiable. Thus, mild ED is an important indicator of risk for associated underlying disease. Main complaint of mild ED should be evaluated adequately. Classification and the causes of ED. Vasculogenic, either cerebrovascular, hypertension, diabetes, neurogenic, central, degenerative disorder or spinal cord trauma, our peripheral type 1 and 2 diabetes mellitus, chronic renal failure, anatomic and structure as hypospadias, micropenis, Peyronie's disease, hormonal as hypogonadism, hyperprolactinemia, and hypercholesterolemia. Drug-induced antihypertensive, antihypertensive, antidepressant, antipsychotic, and psychogenic drugs and trauma. Some of these can be modified, hormonal, by androgen deficiency by itself, it doesn't cause erectile dysfunction. It affects nocturnal erection and decreased libido. Hyperprolactinemia can do erectile dysfunction by decreasing libido and hypogonadotrophic hypogonadism hormones. Many drugs can affect these old patients have combination of drugs. We should follow these drugs. Central neurotransmitter pathways like including serotonergic or noradrenergic dopaminergic pathways, which may disturb the antipsychotic, antidepressant, and centrally acting hypertensive drug, beta adrenergic blocking, thiazide. It's unknown for unknown reason. Don't know the cause is unknown till now. Spironolactone decreased libido and induce gynecomastia. Cigarette smoking do vasoconstriction. Alcohol in a small amount increase erection, while large amount decrease erection. Cimetidine and the histamine H2 receptors act like an androgen, anti-androgen, and cause erectile dysfunction. Other drugs like estrogen and androgenic action like ketoconazole also induce erectile dysfunction. Managing erectile dysfunction, implication of everyday clinic practice. An increasing number of men are currently seeking help for ED due to the growing public awareness of the condition and the availability of effective and safe and user-friendly oral drug therapy. However, not all physicians evaluating and treating ED have appropriate background knowledge and clinical experience in sexual medicine. Thus, men with erectile dysfunction may receive little or no evaluation before treatment and will therefore not receive treatment for any underlying disease that may be causing their ED. Diagnostic evaluation basic first workup is a detailed medical and sexual history. It should be done in a relaxed atmosphere during history taking. This make easier to ask the questions about erectile dysfunction and allow the patient to hear you and explain the diagnosis and therapeutic approach to him and his partner. First, we ask about sexual history. We must include previous and anal and recurrent sexual relationship, current emotional status, onset and duration of the erectile problem, the rigidity and the duration of both sexual stimulation and morning erection, and the problem with arousal and ejaculation and orgasm, and the previous consultation and treatment. It's preferable to stay with the partner in this session to share with her. Validated psychometric questionnaires are present and it's known worldwide. International Index for Erectile Function, it's a 15 question. It analyzes erectile function by 6 question, orgasmic function 2 question, sexual desire 2 question, intercourse satisfaction 6 to 8 question, overall satisfaction 2 question. This gland can be classified by mild, moderate, and severe erectile dysfunction. Also, there is another abbreviation, IEF 5. It's a 5 question abbreviation for 15, and make it easier to use it. If there is in cases of clinical depression, we can ask 2 question scale for depression. During the past months, have you often been bothered by feeling down, depressed, or hopeless? During the past months, have you often been bothered by little interest or pleasure during things? We also ask for possible symptoms of hypogonadism as fatigue, decreased libido, congestive cognitive impairment, decreased energy, or BPH symptoms, which can be assessed by International Prostate Symptom Score. Physical examination, we should focus on the genitourinary, endocrine, vascular, and the neurologic system. Physical examination may reveal unsuspected diagnoses as pyrunias, prostatic enlargement. Rectal examination should be done for patients over 40. Blood pressure and heart rate can be also be assessed. Laboratory tests tailored to the patient complaint and risk factor. Patient may need CBC, fasting glucose, glycated hemoglobin, lipid profile. Hormonal tests include a morning sample of total testosterone. So morning should be done before 10 or 11 a.m. However, the threshold of testosterone to maintain ED is low, and ED is usually a symptom of more severe cases of hypogonadism. Additional tests can be done like PSA, prolactin, and luteinizing hormones. This is a diagram. When the patient came with ED, medical and psychosexual history used, identify other than ED sexual problem as orgasm or whatever, identify common causes of ED, identify reversible risk factors, assess psychological status. Focused physical examination, benign deformity, prostate, sign of hypogonadism, and your cardiovascular neurologic status. Laboratory test, ask for glucose and lipid profile and total testosterone. Special tests present for us are indicated in some cases, like primary ED, young patient with complex psychiatric and psychosexual disorders, patient with complex endocrine disorders. They are nocturnal tumescent spinal rigidity using rigid scan, vascular study like ICI, intracavernous injection of vasodilator drugs, duplex Doppler study, and the dynamic infusion cavernosometry and cavernosography. Intracavernous injection, it's a positive test, is rigid erectile responsive, unable to bend the penis, that appear within 10 minutes after intracavernous injection and for 13 minutes. This response indicates a functional, but not necessarily normal. It can be occur in arterial insufficiency or venous occlusive dysfunction. Penile education and consultation and referral. Consultation with the patient should include a discussion of the expectation and the need for of both the patient and his stable sexual partner if available. It should also review both patient and partner understanding of ED, the result of diagnostic tests, and provide rational selection of treatment option. Treatment option, primary goal in the management strategy of patient with ED is to determine its etiology and treat it when possible. Modified or reversible risk factors, it helps to increase, to treat even the ED and to get better results with oral treatment. The only expectation I was thinking he most possible.
Structure
treatment. Okay. This can be treated by hormonal causes, deficiency of testosterone. This first line therapy is oral pharmacotherapy, which is present in three potent selective 5-PDEF5, tadalafil, sildenafil, and vardenafil. They are not initiators of erection and require sexual stimulation to facilitate an erection. Sildenafil acts within 13 to 60 minutes, reduced by heavy and fatty meals. Efficacy may be maintained for 12 hours. Adverse events are like placebo. It acts on the subgroup like diabetes with a success rate to 66%. Tadalafil is active within 13 minutes to 2 hours. Efficacy maintained for 36 hours. Recommending starting dose is 10 milligrams. Drop out like placebo. In diabetic, it acts with response up to 50%. Vardenafil acts within 13 minutes. It affects diabetic up to 54%. Also, there is a recommended dose on demand.